students and welcome back to Science Space. I am Chaitanya Somaiya and today through this video we are going to study about mercury cells. Mercury cells, you would have heard the name of these cells, but they are rare as they find very few applications because they are costly and they have advantages over use of dry cells. So the advantages include they provide constant voltage supply as compared to dry cells. The voltage supply from the dry cells has some fluctuations. In the previous videos, we had covered many other galvanic cells as well as electrolytic cells. So go through those videos for which the links are provided in the description section below. The topic mercury cell is an important one from the exam point of view, as a compulsory question is asked in the board exams for 3 to 5 marks based on this topic. So study this topic well, and if you have any doubts, you can ask them in the comment section below. Before starting the construction of the mercury cell, let us first understand the uses and advantages of a mercury cell over a dry cell. First of all, let us see its uses. The mercury cells are useful in devices like pacemakers, hearing aids, and electric watches. These are very sensitive devices as the parts of these devices are very small. So mercury cells are very convenient in use in such devices. Now about the advantages, we can say that the mercury cells are more advantageous than the dry cells, as mercury cells provide a constant voltage as compared to the dry cells, because the electrolyte and all the components of a mercury cell are in solid form, so their potential never changes. It remains constant over a period of time, so it provides a constant voltage. Now if we see the construction part of the mercury cell, the main parts of the mercury cell are a zinc anode amalgamated with mercury. The zinc is amalgamated with mercury. What does this mean? Zinc and mercury both form an alloy in the solid form. Then next, a paste of mercury, that is Hg, and carbon powder is made the cathode of this cell. And next, the third part of this cell is a strongly alkaline paste of KOH and ZnO, that is potassium hydroxide and zinc oxide, which act as an electrolyte in this cell. So we will revise these parts. The first part is, यहाँ पर एक zinc anode होता है जिसका amalgam बनाया गया mercury के साथ. Mercury के साथ अगर किसी भी metal का alloy बनाया जाए तो उसे amalgam कहा जाता है. Next, second part है इसका एक और paste mercury और carbon powder का, जिसे cathode बनाया जाएगा इस cell का, which will be the second electrode. And then third part is the electrolyte part. In the electrolyte, there is again a strongly alkaline paste of potassium hydroxide and zinc oxide. यहाँ पर potassium hydroxide और zinc oxide का एक strong alkaline paste बनाया गया. Alkaline मतलब ये basic paste रहेगा जो एक electrolyte का काम करेगा इस cell में. So this was about the construction of a mercury cell. Now in the working of the mercury cell, we will see similar type of reactions that we had seen earlier in the previous videos taking place in the other galvanic or electrochemical cells. That is, there will be redox reactions taking place at the anode and the cathode. Anode will always be the oxidation half cell and the cathode part of the cell will always be the reduction half cell. What is oxidation? We had seen it earlier that oxidation is loss of electrons by a compound, and if the electrons are gained by a compound, then it will be called as reduction. So let us start with the reaction taking place at the anode. At anode, zinc combined with mercury, that is called zinc mercury amalgam, will add to hydroxyl ions from the solution or the electrolyte. There is no liquid solution in this cell. There is a thick paste which acts as the electrolyte or the solution. So hydroxyl ions from the electrolyte that will be moist will combine with the zinc mercury amalgam to form zinc oxide, water in liquid form,
and 2 electrons will be released in this process. This zinc is oxidized here. So this is at the anode, and at the cathode there will be reduction taking place. In this reduction part, mercuric oxide, that is HgO, will combine with this water and 2 electrons from the previous cell. So this combination will give mercury in liquid form, and hydroxide ions will be produced back. So this is the cathode part of the reaction, that is reduction. Here we can see the reduction because 2 electrons are being added to this mercuric oxide. So adding electrons is called reduction, and when we combine these two reactions, we will get overall cell reaction for the mercury cell. In the overall cell reaction, we will add left hand side to left hand side and the right hand side to right hand side of the two half cell reactions. So adding them, we get zinc Hg in solid form plus HgO, that is mercuric oxide in solid form, will give on the right hand side, it will give ZnO solid plus liquid mercury. And the common parts of this reaction, that is H2O in liquid form from the left hand side and right hand side, and 2 electrons will get cancelled from the two sides. Hence this completes the working of a mercury cell. So after mercury cell, go through the previous cells that we had studied in the other videos. For those, you will find the link in the description section below. Go through those videos, ask your doubts, revise them, and solve the questions that are present in every video so that you get your preparation well for the exam. This was all from this video about the mercury cell. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel, as you will get updates regarding other videos related to this chapter.